Hello, my name is José Carlos and I'm from Salamanca. I'm going to make the presentation in English, or at least I try. This presentation is on the communication Mobile Acceptance and Most Preserved Teacher and is elaborated in collaboration with Susana Olmos Miguel Áñez and Francisco José García Peñalvo from the University of Salamanca. In this presentation, I'm going to expose the descriptive results of a study on mobile acceptance on the future teaching practice among the students of a primary teacher's degree in the University of Salamanca. In order to do so, I'm going to follow the same structure as the paper. We will begin with a brief introduction in order to give context to the investigation. After that, I will expose the methodology, the results obtained in the research, and I will conclude with a brief series of conclusions. So, mobile learning is a new methodology that tries to take advantage of the features of mobile devices in the educational context. This methodology has become more and more important every day, overall supported in two aspects. One is the growing presence that has acquired mobile devices in our lives, which is growing, and the other one is the technological improvement experienced by these devices. This technological improvement is especially significant in the cases of smartphones and tablets, which has helped to overcome some difficulties related with the size of the screen, the elaboration of new content, and connectivity. Mobile learning has three main advantages in the educational context. One of them is the individualization of the content. Mobile devices are personal devices, and we can deliver contextualized information adapted to the necessities of our students, of each one of them. This is especially important in context of special education. The second main advantage is the flexibility. We can take these devices anytime to anywhere. So we can take the educational teaching learning process with us. The third one is the communication capacity of the devices that is especially useful in context of collaborative learning. The teachers are key agents in the process of educational innovation, and therefore having the collaboration is essential for the success of the experiences in mobile learning. However, some studies on teachers' attitudes towards mobile technologies have shown some reticencies in them for the use of these devices. Including mobile devices in the educational process delivers a workload with it. The teacher has to learn how to handle the devices and elaborate content adapted to the features of the technologies. Also, they can feel intimidated and doubt of their own capacities to handle the devices and the didactic possibilities of them. The technology acceptance model, TAM, it's a powerful tool for the study of the technology adoption process. This tool has been elaborated by Davis in 1899, and he started from the theories of reason and action and the theory of plain behavior, and proposes two main constructs for explaining the process of technology adoption. These constructs are perceived usefulness, that can be defined as the perception of the improvement that a given IS can produce on a given task, and the perceived ease of use, that can be defined as the perceived level of effort necessary for the use of the IS. These two constructs are related with the attitudes toward using, that includes the beliefs and the values of the user. These attitudes towards the use condition the behavioral intention of using a new informational system, which takes us to the actual use of the system. The technology acceptance model is the more widespread technology adoption theory, mainly for two reasons. One, its theoretical soundness, and the second one is its simplicity, that can explain a relatively high percentage of the variance with a relatively low number of items on a Likert tape scale for each of the constructs. In the field of education, the number of experiences that applies the TAM model in the educational context is growing. and we can find interesting cases both with pre-service and in-service teachers. Also, these investigations apply the TAM model as is, or they modify it, adding another constructs from other theories as external variables that can affect the perceived usefulness and the perceived ease of use. For the development of our model, we maintain the perceived usefulness and the perceived ease of use from the Davis proposal, and we related them directly with the behavioral intention. This is a common thing when developing extended TAM models for the sake of simplicity. We eliminated also the actual use because it's a research on future use of a system, so there is no actual use. We also added two constructs, self-efficacy, that can be defined as an individual's belief in their own abilities to organize and execute the action necessary to manage certain situations. This construct comes from the social cognitive psychology and it's enunciated by Bandura. This concept is related with perceived ease of use and the perceived anxiety, which is mobile anxiety, sorry, which is another one of the constructs that we added to the model. Mobile anxiety can be defined as the degree of apprehension or even fear that an individual feels when he or she faces the possibility of using a computer. This mobile anxiety is linked also with the perceived ease of use. Therefore, the variables that we defined for our study are on the exogenous variables are perceived usefulness, perceived ease of use, the self-efficacy, and mobile anxiety. The endogenous variable would be the behavioral intention of use, and we added other explanatory variables that are age, gender, and the year. Our sample is composed by 678 students from the degree of primary teacher of the University of Salamanca in the three centers of Ávila, Zamora, and Salamanca. By gender, they are distributed 65.2% are women, 34.8% are men. By year, 29.8% are enrolled in the first year, 27.9% on the second, 19.5% on the third, and 22.9% on the fourth. The students has an average age of 21 years old, and nearly 50% are in the interval of ages between 19 and 21. The instrument that we built in order to gather the information is divided in two sections. The first one is dedicated to gather the identification data, including gender, age, and year. The second section is composed by 16 items enunciated in a Likert tape scale, ranging from 0 to 6, being 0 completely disagree and 6 completely agree, adapted from the TAM in the cases of perceived usefulness and perceived ease of use, and from the TAM 3 in the case of mobile anxiety, self-efficacy, and behavioral intention of use. This instrument has a Cronbach alpha of 0.880. The results of TINET show an average punctuation above 4 in all of the items except in mobile anxiety 3 and mobile anxiety 2, which have a punctuation under this level. This shows a relatively positive attitude towards the use of these mobile devices from the students in the future practice. Also, we wanted to comprove if there were significant differences in the average for the variable year. In order to do so, we compare the punctuations, descriptive values, of the groups of students from first year and fourth year. And we observe some differences in their average, some small ones. So, to be sure, we perform a test of normalcy of Kolmogorov-Smirnov and Shapiro-Wilk to determine the normalcy of the distribution of the sample, and we concluded that there were with a rejection of the hypothesis of the normalcy of the distribution. We use therefore non-parametric statistics for the hypothesis contrast. More specifically, Mann-Whitney's U. As we can see here, the results show that there were no significant differences in the average for the students according to the variable year in any of the items. Finally, we wanted to know if there were significant differences according to the variable gender. We repeat the same process as in the variable year, and we compare the means of the two groups, the average. The results show that the males have higher average results in all of the items, and when performing mind-winding issue, we found significant differences in 5 of the items, being mobile anxiety 2, perceived usefulness 1, perceived ease of use 3, perceived usefulness 2, and perceived usefulness 3. In conclusion, we can, in the light of the results, we can establish that there is a positive attitude towards the use of mobile devices among the students participating in the research. This punctuation are slightly above the scores obtained in other results with preservice teachers. Also, there is no significant difference according to the year, which may indicate a lack of proper training or having had few experiences as a student in learning activities. The deepening in and the study of the impact of training and experience in the technology adoption is an interesting topic of research when facing new future investigations. Also, there were some statistical differences for a significance level of 0.05 in 5 of the items according to the gender. The results follow the lines on technology acceptance of other studies on technology acceptance, although there are other studies that haven't found these differences, which suggest that there is needed more deepening in this variable too. Finally, we consider interesting when facing future lines to add another construct and explore other alternatives as previous experience in the daily life and teaching learning styles and how can they affect the technology acceptance. Thank you for your attention. If you have any questions, please.